Welcome to our show. We're heating up the stove. Here to help you relax and keeping it real. We got the best guest. You cannot miss the gist. So come and join us in cooking up a dish.
A show where we marry interesting conversations and very, very delicious meals. I have a very special treat for you today. Our guest today is a household name known for his incredible skits. He was recently featured in the Netflix movie, The Raz Guy, where he got an AMVCA nomination for Best Actor in a Comedy Film. In 2022, he won the Pulse Award for Comedy Influencer of the Year and the Trend Up Award for Comedy Force of the Year. But today, we get to know a different side of this multi-talented individual. Not only is he a celebrated actor and comedian, but also recently embarked on a new journey, the journey of parenthood. Today, we are going to explore the fascinating intersection of showbiz and fatherhood as we sit down with Nusa Afolabi, better known as Lasisi Elenu. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to Lasisi.
What's up, guys? My name is Lasisi Elenu, and I am honored to be a guest on the Relax, Chop, Enjoy with Didi Aswama.
Where are you at? Love to see you.
Oh my God. What's up, mama?
What's up? I am so, so happy to see you.
Well, I'm happy to be here.
It's great to have him. And we're going to talk about you becoming a new dad. Huge responsibility.
A very big one.
A very big one.
A very, very big one.
And because of that, he needs to know how to cook. So today he's going to be cooking for us some stew and rice and plantain.
Well, let me say something real quick.
Uh-oh.
So, hi guys. First, apart from, you know, bringing me on here to talk about fatherhood, which is a big deal. You see, food, if not for comedy, I forget my own sport where I go to sell rice. No.
Really?
It's not a joke. So I don't want you to start looking at it like you need to learn how to cook. No.
Excuse me.
Cooking is me. I am cooking.
I bow.
So today, I'm here to show the world what it's like to be a father that can cook.
Hey!
So brace yourself, lace your shoes, it's about to get down.
My dear, I am going to slide on to this side.
Slide away.
I'm going to slide away because today I'm going to be a sous chef. We have a lot of things going on here. I was a bit distracted, you know, when I was doing your intro because I'm a meat lover. And my dear, there are some tasty things that you're going to put in this. So normally I walk everyone through what we have here before you start cooking it. So we have some goat's meat and beef. They were steam cooked and then fried. You see, my words are kind of jumbled up because my eye did choke for that sight. And then we have some liver and some, what's the native?
Say liver. So liver. Then we don't understand this either.
Oh my gosh. I can't.
We have
it.
Goat meat. And cow meat.
Hey.
They cook them and they fried it. So now you're saying steamed. I want to be mushing. I'm not going to steam. This is liver and shaki.
Hey.
This is pomo. Everybody knows pomo. Hey. This is the meat water. This is Titus fish. It was fried. This is boiled tomato. Boiled pepper. This is steamed tomato. This is iru. And it is woro, it's iru woro. It's not pretest. This is salt. Mona salt, eh? Black costume. Is
it
salt?
It's kosher sea salt.
Jeez, I love it.
It's kosher sea salt.
It's salt, now one salt, like I count the salt. And this is, of course, this is cube. This is seasoning.
Cube.
This is onion. I know I didn't send them this one. They want to spoil my cooking. They want to ruin my cooking. I don't know who sent this thing. What is this?
That is curry leaf.
Swear that you don't want to spoil my cooking.
When
I told you
he didn't ask for this.
Did I tell you he did not
ask for this.
He carry ugu. He carry water leaf. Wants for my
which kind of water leaf? That is not water leaf.
Who said, why are you putting this one here? Did I ask you for water?
Give me my water bottle.
So,
here in the kitchen is the gas stove, and here's the pot that he's going to be cooking.
So they will still introduce the pot again.
Hey. I didn't introduce the pot, but since you're making me, you took me off. I'm supposed to be introducing things,
pot makes
and you didn't let me introduce, so I have to introduce
those
the pot.
Those days, they don't burn you where to use hand rub on that pot of my
house. Imagine!
See pot, has pot clean.
Poverty. What is the pot supposed to do?
Poverty! See! Poverty is not good.
The pot?
See how pot clean, see? Nothing, Baba! Nothing! Don't worry! Don't worry. They burn you where that, when you carry pot, don't do like this. Okay, what are we doing? This is not. I want to do things. I want to.
I am. You know what?
Okay, now what do you want from me now?
What I want from you is just to cook this, and I'll be talking to you about fatherhood.
Oh yeah.
But I fear they catch me now.
You can talk to me.
I am so confused.
Don't be confused. Ask me anything. I can't wait. Because trust me, the journey of fatherhood is one journey that, of course, is new to me. Mm. But it's also very interesting. I'm learning on the job. Nobody prepares you for it. People will always advise you of your smartphone every day. While they do bed at 9, they come and say, hey, now that you are a year older today, remember? So on this journey, it's quite, you know, intense, but it's one that I'm always excited to talk about. So don't worry, we'll have a good conversation.
Okay. So as you start cooking,
yeah,
I'll be asking you some questions.
Okay.
And if you need me to help, support in any way, just let me know. I can't help sometimes because it's like the way you're talking, you're confused. My brain just kind of gets confused because
I don't know this.
But I'm going to try to keep up with you.
Don't worry.
Okay?
Right.
Okay.
Catch up.
What I like to do is kind of start the cooking so people kind of know how we start to cook this meal.
Okay. I'm ready.
Stew.
Girl.
What's the first thing you do?
The first thing I do when I want to make my stew, I have the ingredients on set. I have my my groundnut oil, because this is groundnut oil stew. I'm not making palm oil stew today. I have my groundnut oil heated.
We have olive oil. We don't have groundnut oil.
These are the issues. I grew up with groundnut oil. I did not... Olive oil and anointing oil. We didn't anoint ourselves. You don't... but it goes still sweet. Don't worry. Olive oil, don't worry.
That's what I have.
Don't worry. So I just need that and my frying pan.
Okay.
And the rest is history.
So the olive oil is here. And I'm going to leave you to do what you do.
How did they like this one, oh?
Hey, I knew we were going to go there.
It is, hey God, it is spark. See, don't worry. Those people, don't worry, I didn't wait till they talk. So which one is this one?
It's the middle one.
So how do you start it?
You start it like this. Move your hand before it catch fire.
Hey, they let you know, say, I don't come. Okay.
That's it.
All right. It's gonna be easy, don't worry.
So the first thing I want to ask you is, okay, so I know no one prepares you for fatherhood.
Yeah.
But can you share with us your thoughts and emotions when you first found out that your wife was pregnant?
So it was like several thoughts in my head. Mm. So there is one thing to have. For the longest time, I've had nephews and nieces.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I'm that sweet uncle.
Oh, you're that guy.
I'm that guy.
Mm.
But then, when the thought of me being a father came to light,
mm-hmm,
I could see the difference immediately. I knew this is not just an uncle anymore. This is the feeling my brother has when he calls his daughter or his son. Now I felt it. You know, it's different from, they wanting to see me every now and then.
Mm-hmm.
This is mine. So I'm now asking myself, so I'll have a child that will be born, she'll be 1 year, 4 years, like I always see people's pictures of their kids, this will be mine. So it was very thrilling, you know, thinking about it. And most of the time I just ask myself, would I be that father that is good enough, you know, a father that would be there? I don't want to be an effort father. Mm-hmm. I don't want to, but of course I know people, you can't plan what the future holds. Yeah. You don't know what your children will be.
Yeah.
But then I always felt like, I've always thought about it that I want to be that guy that comes through. I don't want to be the father that is maybe too soft or not too soft or too good or whatever, but I just want to be that guy. So yeah.
You thought a lot. You put a lot of thought into it. Because a lot of people don't be like,
Then I also thought about the financial part too.
That's the part I wanted that part to get to.
I won't lie.
Most people, their first thought is, okay, now I have another mouth to feed.
Yeah.
How is all this going to work out?
So the another mouth to feed is not even, now what are they eating? It's just what is to come.
Mm-hmm.
With this, she did turn her breast milk now. She's a big fan of Eba now, so the Eba is even saving me money.
Oh, that's good. Oh.
Yeah.
Your baby is saving you money.
You see? They want a bonus, oh. They don't talk, eh? Oh, yellow. Wait. So, this is your plan for me, Udeme. You want to spoil my food. I never start pause, don't they?
Wait, it's not my plan now. See? It's...
So, guys, just so you know...
A cooking and talk show. You're supposed to be manning...
No. You now, you know this thing is already about to set a place. You engage me. Guys,
I am not even engaging you.
The first thing I'm putting in my... You see? Why did they put this lump there?
Give me that thing.
Why? So, sorry, guys. The first thing you do as a cook, as a chef, you wash your hands. I don't really touch everything, but you know me. Wash your hands. Let me wash my hands.
Please, and I am going to take the oil. I'm going to turn off the light from the oil before you come and say that I'm the one that's spilling.
No, it's fine. I just don't want you to be distracting me.
But this is the whole point. You're going to be distracted.
So guys, you dab your hand with, you don't have tissue, use rag. Not rag or clean ground or rag, kitchen rag.
I think they know that.
They don't know. Some people don't know. See you. Wait, they do like this now. Why they do like this now? You want to do like say? So
I've turned off the light too.
Then, okay, this works for me. So what we call this is the I don't know.
You may want to wait. That oil is very very hot.
You want to teach me how to cook?
Sorry.
Now you know my oil.
I don't.
Hello,
please.
Banana man.
Please enter there by yourself.
Sister, what's on now?
No. Enter the
guys, place. If your oil never boil, maybe say you go do sharara. You see,
why
after all your shout,
why
see the oil you know you do sharara. She didn't.
That's because I turned it
off. This stew no sweet. Now the meal, my oil don't do sharara. I don't tell you now. Why you go to off my gas? Why you go to off my gas?
The reason I off the gas is because it's a danger.
The oil don't even reach. I'm topping up. We call it oil top up. Oil top up.
You should not have oil on the fire without tending to it, okay?
Why did you say that now?
I didn't say anything.
You want to be confusing my fans?
I did not say anything.
It's my cooking class, not yours. Why are you going to tell me you should not have oil on the fire that works?
I say you shouldn't have oil on the fire without paying attention to me.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. It's true. Mm-hmm. It's true, guys. So you stir, you let it simmer. Let your oil and your...
It's smelling good, actually. I'm very surprised. I thought by now I'll be coughing and choking.
Auntie, now you want to hype me? Now,
but you know that if the oil was burning and you do that, you'll be causing people to cough and choke.
Anyway, let me show you guys my routine.
Okay.
Forget joke.
Back to fatherhood.
Ask me.
Were there any surprises after your baby was born? Were there anything that were surprises to you, or were you completely well prepared for it?
I was not well prepared.
So give us some example of the surprises
I didn't understand why a 2-month-old baby's poop will be smelling more than a 44-year-old man's poop.
How do you know what?
Because she drinks just milk.
No, but they didn't tell you that breast milk really causes your poop to stink.
I didn't know.
It's called organic.
So sometimes look at
organic.
This guy say, who are you? Who really are you?
So you think, say, a person, they come shit in her nappy
and they chop beans, bread, garri, semo,
and your business
is still casual. This girl go your true way. We go only argue who go change them. Why? Anyway, but the things I didn't prepare for was actually the Yeah, sometimes I'm overwhelmed. Mm. And I'm overwhelmed because my wife is overwhelmed. Mm. She's stressed out from taking care of the baby. You know, she has done so much. She's, you know, she has work to do. She has to take care of the house, to fix the house. Mm-hmm. She has to take care of baby. And of course, I can't see her stressed out and I won't be of help. I'm not that dad that just, you know, goes out and lets everything that has to do with the baby be on her alone. So I always have to be involved. But then I'm also stressed out from that.
It's a lot of work.
I'm overwhelmed.
It's 24/7.
I'm looking around trying to understand what's going on, you mm-hmm. know. So it's a lot, to be honest.
So he's taking the cooked tomatoes.
Yeah.
And
I was supposed to say it. So I'm taking the where's the camera? I'm taking the cooked tomato and the
pepper.
Cooked pepper.
Yes.
Wait, other thing are pepper. Everything there.
Yes.
And you know, advise me. Udemy, you are heartless.
You're the one that told me to do it.
I don't mark your face.
You're the one that told me to do that, and I did it for you.
Mona see pepper tomato. Then Mona come see pepper where you man to carry give me.
Is that all?
No problem. So guys, what I do now is to fry my pepper, my tomato. I put it in. Udemy, I don't like the speed of this thing. Oh, did you reduce it?
I did.
Don't reduce my fire. What did it happen now? You want to spoil my food? Why did they reduce my fire now? If not firewood, they use. Why they reduce firewood? Why did they reduce my fire?
It's called safety first. Okay?
Forget safety. See now, they do mere mere. I need that charara sound.
What is charara sound?
Oh, mo, see this spoon.
Mege.
See this spoon. Jamais. Orijo, you spoon like this, Orijo.
You know, he says a lot of things that I honestly must say I do not understand.
So, I'll be putting 4 pastes of the pepper. The food when I go cook for una today, hey God, you know say I be Yoruba Benin boy.
You're just putting 4?
Yeah, I put 4.
That's it?
Yeah. I don't want to be too peppery now. I don't know if some people don't like pepper too
okay,
much.
That's
I'm that guy. I'm that cook.
He is a very thoughtful person.
Now what for you?
As he just went through.
I'll come cook food. People not go taste the food. No. How they do like that?
This guy.
So I stir my food.
Let me smell it and see.
Hey. Come, it's this your only boy, I don't understand the oil.
It's smelling very good. It's smelling very good.
I don't understand this your oil.
Okay, what do you mean? Which oil?
This is your olive oil, yes.
What's wrong with olive oil? Olive oil is a very good
I'm
oil.
Not seeing it come up, like.
See it come up how?
It's not.
Oh, so you want it to be scattering everywhere? Wait
like,
now. Wait, I turned down the fire.
You see, these are the issues I have with. Let me tell you something. I came from the street. Now, in the street, what makes your food?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you ever went to Mama Put.
Of course.
God bless you.
Ghana High.
What made Mama Put food sweet?
Mm-hmm.
I'm asking. It was those dirty things.
I was about to say, the environment.
The environment.
Yes.
Do you eat any rice and you are seeing 4 lizards looking at you?
It adds, even some of the
you
things
know,
that they are putting in there add some
she
extra.
She cleaning her sweat and using that same hand to squeeze
yes.
Maggi.
Yes.
Blowing
you know,
all those
they are
things.
Cooking,
so,
you know, they do like this.
No, they, you know. But anyway, guys, so what's on the stove now is my. I don't hear the charara. Nice one.
Charara is going on.
Hey.
I turned on the fire. So, you are a very thoughtful father because you think about, you know, making sure that you two support each other, you and your wife support each other.
Yeah.
One of the things I know about being a new parent that you cannot avoid is sleep deprivation.
Mm.
Because no matter what you do, you're going to encounter that.
Yeah.
So what are some of the strategies that you guys use to make sure that each of you get enough sleep? Because babies just sleep like a couple of hours and that's it.
Honestly, there wasn't any strategy for it.
So what did you...
It was, like I said, so I think it's for people who, I don't know, but in a nutshell, we just faced every day as it came. There was no plan. There were plans, but we never saw the plans through because the baby is not some sort of project. It's not a formula. You that you say, okay, do, because they were routines, everybody advised, oh, may the baby sleep for afternoon. If you sleep for afternoon, if you not sleep for afternoon, she will sleep all through the night. I say, well done. You've not met my daughter.
Every baby is different.
You've not met that girl. She would they look you eyeball to eyeball like she want to rub your wallet. I tell you my pikin, you know they look me like that. This girl will be looking at you eyeball to eyeball as if she's about to surprise you with something. So, yes, we always had that thought of, oh, there was something we could do. But we just, most times, it just happened. We wake up, we do what we can do, especially when we, you know, when we gave birth to her, it was worse, you know, because we didn't have help. Hey, my sister, the bono. We didn't have help. I think I'll need more oil. I don't like the way, no, I'll need more oil. So what I'll do, okay, just.
Let me help you. Let me just put oil for you.
Because it's not.
You've been treating this oil as if it's
okay,
anointing
it's okay.
Oil.
It's okay. Anybody anything to do my stew now with the mail. I don't send a little way they pour put. But it's okay.
So not to confuse people, who Udeme is, that's also me, because...
Sorry, I know it's not Udi, they call you Udimi.
Didi,
Udimi. So like I was saying, so we didn't have a proper plan. Yes, especially when we were in the States, you know, when we had her, we didn't have help. We pretty much did everything ourselves. You know, my wife she tried.
I have heard people, I've heard some horror stories. I remember a friend told me that once they woke up in the middle of the night screaming at their newborn babies, not because of you, that we're not going to sleep.
I'm telling you.
Because it can be trying. You know, sleep deprivation is real.
We were cranky. We were uptight.
Yeah.
We were...
That's what happens.
We're not the yuppie, jovial type of... We were just tense. Mm. It's not a funny thing.
It's exhausting.
And people who have lived it understand what I'm saying. I would, you know, things that were supposed to make us laugh sometimes don't even make us laugh. Mm. Because this one is moody, I'm trying to get out of my mood. Mm. She's in her feelings. Mm. It was hard. So the sleep thing was not really, we couldn't do much about it.
Yeah.
There were nights we were lucky, the baby would sleep. You know, we'll still wake up at interval and help out, you know, change her diaper and all of that, you know.
If you're trying to turn the light down, that's the wrong direction.
Stop that. Don't do that. Why do you want me for you? She's not because see, I come from street. I don't know how to reduce gas. You know, so it, all of that was, you know, compound. There was no routine. We just managed to scale through.
You just adapt.
You have to really adapt. Yeah, okay. That's what it was.
So one of the things that always interests me is finding out that aha moment in parenting. Like, is there an aha moment that you realize the importance of your role as a father? Because it's one thing, you know, you had your nieces, your nephews, you were really involved in their lives, but now you have your own child. Did you have like one moment that thing, it really hit you that, you know what, I am responsible for you for the rest of your life?
I think yesterday she came out, we're just done baiting her. So I was trying to, most times I always help her to like put on her clothes and everything. And when I was looking at her, you know when you say something is, now you get them, like now your own.
Mm-hmm.
So I was looking at her like, she was just smiling, trying to fight me and do all those playful things. And in my head, I didn't want to start talking to her like an adult. I was like, Gray, do you know that that is your friend? Do you know that that is your best friend? Because she was so cute. And of course, there are several times I look at her, I'm like, I'm so blessed, you know. And I pray for people who are out there who want, you know, to have children.
Mm-hmm.
I pray God bless them because it's a beautiful thing. And yes, every time I look at her, I'm still overwhelmed and I'm like, wow, now my pikin be this. This is my child.
It's
not
amazing.
Someone else, not my niece, not my nephew, mine, you know, and I would help nurture her to be the woman she's supposed to be. So yeah, every time. Mama, don't worry yourself. Mama, check my stew.
I love them.
Mama, check my stew.
And, Udeme,
this is it.
Now you have the right balance.
Oh.
Udini. Now you say it was my fault.
Udini. Collect. Uncle.
So one of the things, another thing that I always, you know, like to hear about is balance. Because you had your life. When you're single, you have a particular lifestyle. When you're married, that lifestyle changes. When kids come in, that lifestyle changes again. So how do you balance your personal life, your work life? I mean, you're a very busy person. You do your
skin. I don't get personal life again. I don't get personal life. They don't tie me down. Which one we say the, your business? They don't tie me down. Don't bump it in. I'm not a married man with kids.
But you have to always have balance. You have to have balance.
When you know my decision, money, sure you don't know my gist. Sure they don't tell you my story. Me will be saying, are they run things for streets? Are they run things?
So what happened?
The balance, the balance is still not easy. Like I said, so this is me. This is me personally. I am the kind of person that it is by nature. Mm-hmm. I cannot see someone in need mm-hmm. or need some sort of assistance mm-hmm. and not offer it. Mm-hmm. Now this person is my child, my wife. Mm-hmm. So what I'm trying to say is I have work. There are things that are very important I have to do. Mm-hmm. However, the balance mm-hmm. most times it's not balancing, because if I've said I have to do this at a particular point in time and this other one has to chip in mm-hmm. as a result of me being who I am by virtue of myself mm-hmm. I find myself neglecting this for this,
compromise.
No regrets. I'm excited about it. Yes, I might have loose ends every now and then. I might not be able to meet up with certain things when I'm supposed to. I might feel like, oh, I've missed out on a few things. You know, there are times I'm dedicating some things. Even when I was when we had rain, mm-hmm. you know, I was in America for months. I missed out on jobs. I wanted to do people, we don't say you still did outside. You know, people in actual context call it paternity leave. I did not need a paternity leave because I needed the money. Right. But then I wanted to compromise it severally, but it wasn't work. I felt I have to do this. However, in the long run, I've still been able to balance it up. I've still been able to say, okay, you know what? I measure up the ones that I feel like are of more value, importance. And I said, okay, this job I can, you know, pretty much just do without it. It's not going to change my entire well-being. So let's let that go. Let's focus on this. Let's, you know, oh, Ray needs to be here for this. Oh, Ray needs to do this for that. Oh, let's try to make this happen, you know. And, you know, so that's it.
What advice would you give to a father out there that may be struggling with trying to balance? Because a lot of people, you know, especially as a new father, it can be really hard.
I don't know.
Is there a tip that you could give them?
I don't know for that person. No.
I try to be serious.
It's true. I don't know for anybody, Papa, for outside, though. Let me go advise you. You go to your church on Sunday, go first service, second service, third service. When you finish, you go see advice. You don't see Nigeria, you see America where they stay. This Nigeria, they're going to say, idiot, because you don't mind, I want to advise me. I don't want to advise anybody. They were saying that last month I married, who I be to advise? I don't want to advise. Go anywhere your eyes, see, collect her. If you like, carry your picky, throw her up, no catch her. Now you sabi. If you like, catch her and say that you be that
don't
girl.
Don't do
here.
That.
No, I just did. That's the thing. My student, they bought. So, no, but for real, well, the balance is that. I know you, if you are naturally, if you want to be there for your family, mm-hmm. I'm sure you'll find a balance.
Yeah.
You don't need somebody to tell you. It's human. We're human. We know how to.
You make the adjustments.
We know when to. If you really want to.
Prioritize.
Babies know how to just automatically know they are supposed to feed off their mother.
That's true.
Nobody told them that. It's
That's
just reasoning.
True.
It's just the way they were built. So as a father, I'm sure by your existence, you just will find that balance. It might take time. It might not be, some other people might find it sooner than you do, but then I'm sure you eventually would get there. So
it sounds like it's initial desire.
Yes.
If you want to do this, you're going to figure it out, how to
we'll
get it
go
done.
Without your English, that initial desire where you talk, that's it. That's it.
I just can't help myself.
That's it. Now the life, oh, see, you want to go the advice negotiate Nigerians. They will gossip me for social media, me. No, I know they do. So say like this, see, because you're married 2 months ago, you want to tell me, if I'm not the advice, you. I know which are the talk.
Okay,
who.
We understand.
All right. So I think I changed my mind about this, the teen tomato. So now,
that pepper is strong, oh.
You see, it's not for the wisdom of God.
That pepper is strong.
So guys, when you want to use your meat water, you taste it. Why are you tasting it? To know if you have the kind of condiments, ingredients in it, so that when you are putting your Maggi, your salt and everything, you don't overdo it. Wisdom, no go kill me.
Now that is wisdom. Now that one is advice.
Hey.
So some of the resources that you leveraged, you know, having a newborn baby is very difficult to do it yourself.
Mm-hmm.
So what are some of the resources and support that you leveraged to help you? Or did you have, there are people that don't have any support. They just do it on their own.
My God, now, my wife is the only this and God. There's no other resources. Which resources is that one? Follow me, man, put this inside water, they come. Which resources is that one?
Let me see what is doing.
So guys, you do this, see, you do it. Excuse me, let the camera see it. Like this.
Why are you doing it like that?
We call it marination process.
Marination process?
Marination process. We call it top up. Anything you want to call it, just call
what
it.
What type of
so you put small.
You pour that thing in there?
You put small. Hey God. So now for a few more minutes, it's going to simmer. When it simmers, I put in the fish, the rice, this one, all of this.
There's
thing.
No rice.
Sorry, the meat. Now, we call it synchronization.
Synchronization.
Oya lele.
You're synchronizing, putting
hey
the meat.
God.
Chef.
Hey God.
Lasisi.
You did ask me something earlier. You say.
On seat today.
You say, wait till you do person, Papa. You asked me something earlier.
I don't remember.
Yeah.
What do you mean? What are you talking about?
Normally,
I'm talking about support. Like, what support do you leverage as a, you know, because as a new, it's hard to do everything yourself.
That's what I'm saying.
You know, I know in our culture, sometimes you have people that will come, you know, extended family to support and help you.
Oh, yeah,
that stuff is not easy.
Oh, okay. So my mother is not alive. Mm. My wife's mother is not alive.
Mm.
We both have our fathers.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, they are.
Yeah.
They are just of moral support. Yeah. Mm. So I think my wife's aunt comes once in a while, you know, to help.
So
to
you
help
guys
out.
Have really done this on your own.
Now what for you? You did. Share you want they whine me for you. They tell you say person don't go through something. See my eye, muscle dey my eye line. You know they hear wetin I dey talk. I'm telling you, it's not been easy.
But you know what? Seriously, that is commendable because it's very, very hard. Mm. Those of you know that thing is not easy.
See.
You need support.
Sometimes to be very honest, my wife, she did there. There are times I don't even really, she did try.
Mm.
Mm. Sometimes I didn't look at somebody go corner, go smoke, it go and on the siam. Because she could do like, say, a German machine.
She's like a militant, militarized.
But according to that, you go to a post, they find airport. Now, lah, they find a go. I want to know whether this woman, they take something. But she's not a drug addict. I'm like, what do you do and how do you do
have
what
that,
you do?
All that energy that she...
So I won't lie to you. She's been... Yeah. So let me say, since you asked about the support system, she's the support system. Then maybe she's the support system to her own self. No, I'll be support system to her now. She want the one. Since the money, now small picking for your eye. That is important too.
That synchronization, as you did.
Oh, lele! Hey, Udimi! No worry! Hey, my student is born. No, it is done.
No, but that is commendable because, you know, it's not an easy thing to do. Anyone that's a new parent out there that's listening understands the hard work that he's talking about because it's not easy.
So
we're going to start with...
I want to put my meat The fish I put it last because I don't want it to break.
Okay.
So I put in the liver and the shaki. I put some of this is a lot of meat, so I put some of it.
Okay.
And I put a little bit of the kpomo. Mm-hmm. Then I put this last. I add my water to it. I add some water to it.
Mm-hmm.
And we have our stew ready.
That's it.
Now what to you?
That's it.
If you like, say we play for your you didn't want.
Oh wow. Okay. So as he's starting the synchronization process, really bringing these two together, making it all join, I think this is a good time for us to take a break and complete cooking. And we'll be right back to
asking
maybe one or two more questions. We are coming back to ask him some questions, okay, that he's going to answer this time.
How do you go for commercial break? You say coupon or brion?
There's no pion, okay. It's cut.
All right.
So we'll be right back to close things out and we will have our rice and stew ready for you to see what it looks like. Let's see if Chef Lasisi can deliver on his promise. Lasisi, aka Chef Dynamite.
It's not Dynamite. It's called Billy Dynamite.
Sorry, I missed the Billy.
Chef part. Billy Dynamite.
Billy Dynamite. He didn't blow up the kitchen, but he has given us some bomb stew, okay? And we're getting ready to dig into it. But before we dig into that, I have just one last question for
you. I'm already with my fork, buddy. Yeah, yeah.
I am afraid now.
Don't worry.
So how has being a new father changed your priorities in life?
I think in a lot of sense, it definitely has. I think anyone who is in a position of being a father,
mm-hmm.
you just suddenly see yourself as a protector, a provider, mm-hmm. a father figure, you just want to make sure the things that were not necessarily a priority before
mm-hmm.
will start to become one. Because now I just always want to make sure my home is fine.
Mm-hmm.
Things that would throw anyone off balance, I want to make sure I, take it out of my... Now I'm not... it's my reactions or my perspective is subjective to the thoughts I have in my head as to making my home work.
Mm-hmm.
I am not if something feels like it doesn't sit well in the confines of my home and it's mm-hmm. affecting the well-being of everyone there, it's not a conversation. I just do away with it
mm-hmm.
because I don't want anything to put my family in mm-hmm. in jeopardy,
mm-hmm.
put them in a space where I feel like I've done wrong.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? So my perspective has, really changed my way of thinking.
Mm-hmm.
I want to, everything I'm doing is for them first.
Mm-hmm.
Then other things are secondary. They are primary. And I didn't think I would be that guy,
mm-hmm.
but I just found myself there. I didn't learn it. I didn't go to school for it.
Mm-hmm.
Not like I actually went to see someone and said, okay, tell me now, what do? I pretty much would have forgotten.
Mm-hmm.
But I just saw that by reflex,
mm-hmm.
I just started to do those things that, in turn, made, could, there was a clear difference that this is not how I used to be,
mm-hmm.
and this is who I am now. So yeah.
Amazing. Amazing. It has been so awesome having you with us, and
can
you've given
now?
Us a lot. Wait now.
Sorry, I finished. Sign out. Do your thing.
I go sign out.
I know job come your show. I was planning on eating.
Yes, viewers, we were a bit hungry before we started cooking, and he's going to start eating the food. I beg, please.
Is it? I didn't know.
You chopped food now. I saw you pick one piece of rice.
Me?
Yes.
Okay, I say let me just taste from this drink. Let me carry out this thing from there.
I beg, tell our viewers how to get some Relax, Chop, Enjoy content, please.
Please subscribe to the YouTube channel Relax, Chop, Enjoy, and follow us on social media, on all social media platforms. That's what's up. That's how we do. That's how we roll. You know what I'm saying?
And I was going to try to close us out with some sort of words of wisdom, but it seems as if we need to start eating, okay? So, to get more information and to learn more about Lasisi and all the great work he's doing, please visit at Lasisi Elenu on Instagram and Facebook. Of course, everybody knows who you are already.
Everybody does not know. Don't whine me. Can we eat this food?
A lot of people will get to know you very, very soon. Yes, we can eat the food, but
now, small thing they make.
I want to thank all our viewers for joining us once again. And always remember to relax, chop, and
I have left you. We're I cannot first, wait though. For you anymore.
I need to. I'm the one that's supposed to be tasting the food now first. I need to taste the food first.
God, I beg me the food sweet. I use God, beg.
Say prayers.
Father, if you are the Father, if you created the world in 7 days, if you said, let there be light, and there was light, if you said, touch my anointed and do my prophet no harm, if you did it, Lord, I put it to you, Lord. Lord, if you are the Lord.
Last thing.
Why me?
Chef,
make me I chop.
It's good, though.
Make me I chop my problem.
The food is good, though. I am actually surprised.
You can't taste food. Let me like perfume. You know me smell perfume from television.
It's actually good. Oh my God.
You didn't want. You didn't want.
You did it. You finished work. You finished it.
What's all this now?
He didn't leave anything.
What are the devil and say they run this thing? What are the things and they play for here? What's all this now?
He did it. I am actually shocked, to be honest. Okay, so now we are gonna close things out. So thank you so much for joining us yet again. And until next time, remember to relax, chop, and enjoy. What do we gonna call this soup?
Italia fecalia pali. Italia fecalia pali.
Is it fetalia?
3, 2, 1. Italia petalia pali.
Italia petalia
fali.